I like questions that are about animals.
I like questions about food and things.
I like questions about the sun.
I like questions that make you think.
The questions the teacher asks in the classroom are very important to help students think about different ideas. The teacher asks a balance of broad and narrow questions. Broad questions create links between the known and the unknown.
What can you tell me about the way that the tomato sauce is?
Quite often teachers can get caught up in feeding people for answers. And I think if you ask really broad questions, you leave that door open for children to interpret the question and answer it in a way that perhaps you had not anticipated. And I think that's really valuable because you're touching on all sorts of ways of thinking and the ways that the children are understanding the information that you're giving them.
Broad questions are important to draw out prior knowledge and learn about students' understandings and misconceptions about a concept. Broad questions give the chance for the whole class to contribute to the discussion. Narrow questions, on the other hand, have only one answer. Narrow questions are useful for focusing on students' ideas. It's also important for teachers to give students time to think about what they have asked.
What was the evidence that we collected and that we are now to present?
Research shows students learn better if a wait time of more than 3 seconds is allowed. More responses are obtained if the teacher waits a second time before replying to a student or asking another question.
When you see a child put their hand up after you've asked a question, it's really tempting just to pick that child, but quite often it can be the same child over and over again. And some children think at different rates, and it's really good to see if you leave that wait time that a few more kids put their hand up that perhaps you think, wow, I didn't think that that child would be able to answer it.
You're encouraging children not to just think of the first thing that comes into their head, but you're making them really think. Really, really think and challenge themselves. Is this right? Am I going to say the right thing?
I think the answers that are given, if you leave a bit of wait time, are far more thought through. You get much more of an open understanding, and also the children feel, rather than giving a closed response, that they can elaborate or justify why they're giving you a response, which is really great as well, because that's often the follow-up question.
By listening carefully to students' responses, the teacher can ask questions that build on what students already understand. At the start of a unit, it's helpful to ask open questions that encourage students to discuss their ideas and experiences. Teachers move around from group to group and ask questions that help students express their ideas and think about the task they're engaged in. As the class moves through the unit, questions should become more focused and reinforce the explanation of the concept. As the unit is completed, in the evaluate phase, questions should help to assess students' understanding about the concept that has been explored. Often these questions are the very questions used in the engage phase. However, it should be clear how the students' ideas have developed.
Questioning the children in the right way, you really get a deeper understanding of what they actually know and what learning has taken place.
You have the waiting time and then a child answers. And it's like this light going on.
And they'll often come out with the most amazing answers to a question.
It's fairly goosebumpy. Yes, I get fairly emotional just to see the responses from the children.
It's a fantastic feeling. I think it's a reason why teachers teach. So you can see those faces light up and say, oh, wow, they've actually learnt this because of what we're doing. So it's a fantastic feeling.
Yeah, it's wonderful for as a teacher.
When questioning, ask a balance of broad and narrow questions. Allow sufficient wait time and listen carefully to students' answers so follow-up questions build on what students already understand.